Well, hey there, everybody. Welcome back to the Darkest Dungeon. I don't know why it sounded so, like, goofy and formal. Let's try that again, shall we? Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the Darkest Dungeon here in week 26 or 27. I think it's week 27, actually. We have got ourselves a job to do here, and that job is demeaning either taking out the Swine Prince, who I do have the Wounding Helmet for, or we could go fight the Sonorous Prophet. I kind of want to go fight the Swine Prince just because I really don't like that fight, and I think that we've got a pretty interesting strategy here. So I am going to be fighting the Swine Prince. We're going to put Tempo. We'll get Northern Lion in here, even though he's level 1. I still think I'm going to be okay with his buffs. We need a healer, though. I think we can bring Kate or Marie. Let's see. Do either one of them have a Warren's buff? Yes. So Marie does. So we're going to bring Marie, and then for our tank, we can go, we'll probably be okay with either Dodger or Strippin, to be honest. Let's see. We're not gonna be doing a dark run. Yeah, you know, let's go ahead and bring Strippin along. He's Strippin, Sam, his am, I am, something like that. I am a little bit worried about damage, though. But with Tempo, we should be okay. I'm just going to assume everything's okay. So we're gonna go Brawler's Gloves for Strippin. And we'll also give him a Sun Ring just to help him out with that accuracy. Because Lord knows, if there's one thing that the lepers don't have in this game, it is accuracy and a whole lot of other things. But it's all right. Northern Lion here, we'll give him the Lucky Dice. And we shall also give him... I think we can give him the Critical Dice. It's fine with me. And then for Tempo, we've got ourselves the... I don't really need those. Yeah, there we go. Vengeful Greaves. My brother Tempo, and then we'll also go with we could up his dodge, but I don't want to drop his crit. I also don't want to drop his speed necessarily. I think we could just we could be okay with dropping his speed by 1 and giving him more accuracy. I'm okay with that. Alright, now, talking about the interesting strategy here for the Swine Prince, something that I haven't really shown before, is the Rallying Flare. Now, the reason why Rallying Flare is going to be important here is because this allows us to pretty much clear the marked targets of Wilbur, and I think that's something that you're going to be seeing a little bit later on in this run. So I'm going to be getting that. I'm going to be using the Battlefield Bandage here, even though Blind Fire will be kind of helpful. I'm going to upgrade it nonetheless, but primarily we're going to be using the Rallying Flare for just the Swine Prince fight. So we're okay now, but I need to make sure, hopefully I remember to swap to that. So let's see, Strippin's good. Marie definitely needs the upgrades here. We'll go ahead and upgrade Judgment as well in case she gets shuffled. And then I think NL is due for a round of upgrades. No, actually he's not. Let's see, Dirk Stab would be okay, but I think we're okay with just with what we've got. We'll give him solo just in case he needs to step in front of anything. Make sure everyone's got their upgrades here. Marie needs an upgrade. Strippin needs an upgrade. Tempo needs an upgrade. All right, let's do it. Let's go kill us a Swine Prince. Been looking forward to this one. I've been looking forward to and not looking forward to it just because this fight is so... This fight's very, very... unpredictable, I think, is the best way I can describe it. You have to be super duper cautious with the amount of damage that, especially the amount of damage that that Wilbur can do at the end of the fight. So, I think we're ready. Let's do it.
The ways and rituals of blood sacrifice are difficult to master. Those from beyond require a physical vessel if they are to make the crossing into our reality. The timing of the chance is imperative. Without the proper utterances at precise intervals, the process can fail spectacularly.
All right, so there is the narrator setting us up.
Abomination, a testament to my failures. It must be destroyed.
We are not going to do anything fancy here. We're just going to go right for the Swine Prince. Now, again, this is going to be a light run, so I did bring ample amounts of torches. And killing the boss should always be first priority. I know that sounds kind of herpa-derpa, but it needs to be said, you can't afford to get distracted when you're doing boss runs. You just get in there, get the boss killed first, and then after that, worry about getting loot and that sort of thing. So we are going to take down the Acolyte next to Tempo. I think we can get a Hue here. Got the double kill, actually. Wow. All right. Not going to complain about that. Got a couple deeds, too. I like it. More crests, okay. And again, We want to make sure we get the maximum potential out of our sun ring for stripping. Obviously, going up against the wretch is going to be something a little bit sad face. We need to drop the let's drop the accuracy and damage of the chopper, just because they can do a pretty nasty stun. And L is going to get vomited. And would you know, the game goes one for one with diseases, so there's that. And they're just going to try stacking the stress on Northern Lion here. And apparently we're also all really, really slow in this group. What is your disease resist? 20, huh? Alright. I really, really need to start killing the stress now, but we also need to start killing things now. Even though it's only turn one, we do have a little bit of a pressing issue with taking down at least the wretch. So there's the miss there on NL, which is good. And I think that using Intimidate here, which would drop the damage and accuracy of the chopper even further, is probably good. And now we're going to slice off another one, stacking the bleeds. We have a lot of damage coming on here. Let's see. All we have to hit the chopper for is two, and he's dead. And yeah, I think we just do that. So chopper is out of here.
Is the weapon
that's gonna shift everyone up. Gonna try to push Strippin. Hopefully he resists it. He did. Strippin super slow. I'm actually surprised at how slow tempo is. But we should get a double kill here with the Hue. Take her out. I'm gonna decide to delay here. We only need to. Oh, he's dead anyway. So I'm actually just going to withstand here. The wretch dies to Northern Lion's bleed. So. And I don't want to kill the brawler quite yet because I want Northern Lion to at least get a little bit of that stress down. What does Vertigo do anyway? I forget. Vertigo is minus 50% move resist. All right. We'll go for a blind fire here. We got the kill. That's all right. We were able to kill a little bit of NL stress. Lots and lots of items. Go ahead and crack open this chest here. More crests is okay. We'll get rid of one of the jades. So the Swine Prince is almost always up here on the top right. Almost always. There are occasions where he will spawn down bottom, but I think that it's usually always up to the top right. Hopefully we proc a scouting here. Purchase,
spirits are lifted, and purpose
okay,
is
we did proc
clear.
Scouting, so they're usually up top. No, it's actually bottom. Alright. Oh, what am I doing? We need to go camp first. Silly, silly me. Zinvicta, you trying to kill everyone here, nerd? I think I am.
A spark without kindred.
I'm gonna take the feast just to heal everyone up and get rid of the stress as much as possible. I don't think we have any disease removal here. Yeah, we don't have a plague doctor, so yeah, there's nothing really we can do. Let's see, Tiger's Eye. We want to definitely buff up tempo, restring crossbow. Tempo's gonna be our primary DPS here. I prefer us to not get ambushed here at nighttime, just because I don't want to waste. I don't want to possibly get any bad afflictions going into there, especially if it's a disease or something. And then we might as well just use Encourage on NL. So tempo is going to be our bread and butter here.
A blazing star.
And we are just going to rock the house here. Now, admittedly, I'm kind of sandbagging it a little bit, but the Swine Prince isn't that hard. I forgot to use the flare! Oh well. I forgot to use my rallying flare. You should have told me, Twitch chat. Why didn't you? It's all right. Well, ideally here we would have rallying flare and we'd be able to get rid of the mark on tempo. But thankfully we have a way to nerf his damage too, thanks to Hand of Light. So, yeah, it's totally my bad on that. I remembered it literally as soon as we were like walking in here. Right, so tempo's gonna mark the target. We can also use Sam to intimidate, but again, as I was just saying before we got into this room, this fight on this difficulty is really it's a no-brainer. I mean, it's dangerous, but don't put too much thought into it. Especially if you have so many ways to debuff his damage, like minus 50% damage is pretty massive. 37 crits by tempo. We can even use Intimidate if we really want to get cute and drop his damage even more. Yeah, he's doing minus 76% damage, and he's still crit for 17. So that would have one-shot Marie. There's the mark from Wilbur. I really wish I had kept Rallying Flare, man. My bad. If we lose someone on this, it's because of me and my own incompetence. Start stacking the bleeds here, but this fight's basically almost over. 47 crit from stripping. As soon as tempo goes, ball game. Yeah, easy peasy. Now is actually the more dangerous of the part of the fight, because Wilbur can actually chain stun your entire team in almost indefinitely. And if you have anyone who's on who's teetering on the brink of death's door for Wilbur, it can get kind of precarious. Yeah, so down goes Swine Prince. He's already dead. Nothing, no really crazy doings here. Yeah, we'll go ahead and take the move stone just to sell it. Of course, we're not going to be done though. We're just getting started, game. I don't know what you are thinking about. But anyway, let me look at Rallying Flare. So yeah, so we would clear the stun, clear the marked target, and we also get a 15% debuff resist as well as a plus 5 to torch. So yeah, this is just a non-pro tip coming from a non-pro. If you fight the Swine Prince, you're gonna want to have an Arbalest if you can help it that has Rallying Flare. Later on in the medium, especially in the medium level missions and higher, the champion level missions, like you need to be able to purge that mark. Otherwise, you see how much damage. And this is on like apprentice mode. You can really, really hurt the Swine Prince's damage a whole lot. Now, that being said, if you don't have that option, then I highly, 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 highly recommend getting a vessel that has at least Hand of Light. Ideally, you want multiple ways to debuff their damage as often as possible in the same round. So, like, we had Strippin and Marie doing that to the Swine Prince. So, I think that's the best tips I can give you for later on in this, later on down the line, whenever you get to the mid game and late game stages of Darkest Dungeon. We're gonna take down the butcher. I forget the name of that. It's whatever. It's the slicer. Super duper dangerous. You really don't want to mess with the amount of damage they can put out. They only have 8 HP anyway, and they're really easy to kill. So yeah, very very clean fight though. No big deal. Get a round of healing off for Marie. And I think that I think we can do a little bit of stress healing here. I don't think there's anything wrong with that. 24, man, oh man. Strippin is swinging for the fences. English horrors, brought low and driven into the mud. So we know that there's going to be a fight in this next room. Might as well go to Radiant Light. No reason not to. We've got ourselves a wretch, a drummer, and 2 brawlers. Should be able to take them out pretty easily. And, yeah, we're just going to get diseases because that's just how it goes. Again, going back to what I was talking about in the last episode, I do think that it's a little too easy for the game to give diseases. Might just be my own RNG biased opinion, but it does seem to happen way too often. And for the amount of inconvenience it hits you with, it's kind of annoying. Buff everyone's damage up. Yeah, let's go ahead and take out that wretch real quick. Trippin', we might be able to get a kill on the brawler here. Yeah, 47. We kind of killed him, I guess. Wow, everyone just critting their brains out right now. Another crit. We're at Radiant Light, by the way. We're not in a dark run status here, team. You're gonna throw your back out or something. I'm worried about this team. I mean, they put the fire in the Cheerios this morning, I guess, which makes no sense. I don't even care. Got a lot of gold. I'm gonna get rid of the medicinal herbs for more gold. Or is it merely? We probably don't need the holy water anymore. I'll take the bus, and we're gonna use our last key here. So I think we'll be okay with getting rid of the bandage. More busts and crests. Do a little bit more exploring. 2 deeds, okay, I'll take it. I'd like to get to at least this room here. I'm not going to do a full clear, but I'd like to at least get to that treasure room here. Alright, so we've got these are called slashers, by the way. We've got the leg up on the enemies here. It's going to go for crazy good damage. Sam gets a smackdown. We need to take out one of them. The wretch was really the only guaranteed kill we have. Surprisingly, the madmen have a lot of dodge, and they can surprise you with like a really nasty When they go on a dodging streak, it's so annoying because of how much stress damage they can do with Doomsday. This right here. So I'm just going to heal up because we have no way of hitting the back line except for tempo. Get rid of a couple of the corpses. I think we might be okay to delay once here, but there's no reason to risk it. And L can take care of the stress on Marie. We've got another shovel. We're actually back up to three shovels, which is quite funny.
Push on to the task's end.
Right now we're just going for gold, man. We might as well explore down here, then we're gonna make a beeline to the western area of the dungeon. Set of torches. I'd like to hold on to one torch in case we do find scrolls. Strength to follow it. We're getting quite a bit of gold here. Again, you really don't ever want to hold on to Jade or Citrine unless you're done with the dungeon, because they can only stack to 1,000 gold, and they're only worth 250 gold each, so it's not that big of a deal. Ooh, look at that. Unfortunately, we don't have a key. That's depressing. That is depressing. Well, we're gonna hit up the secret room. But first, I'm gonna see if we can get a key out of this. If we can get a key out of this room, that'd be nice. Gonna burn two torches here. One more torch, man. We've blown through all these torches. Hopefully, we can get a key out of this. I am gonna go to the secret room regardless. But obviously, if we have a key, that's gonna give us more. That'll give us more treasure. I think we can just go for broke here. Marie's gonna get a smackdown kill on the Carrion Eater. And I was gonna get stunned by the... No, he didn't get stunned, actually, by the chopper. It's interesting. Normally, when that attack hits and it procs the move, it also usually procs the stun as well. Up everyone's accuracy and crit up a little bit. Go straight for the wretch. Man, Tempo is just... I don't even know what to say, man. He's just going ham. Pun intended. Might as well try to get a crit heal off. I mean, there's no danger right now. A little stress mitigation. We have 7 shovels. I take that back. I'm an idiot. I didn't realize we had that many shovels. That's a little redonkulous, I gotta say. The amount of shovels we have. How did we get 7? Nice dodge by Marie. Blind fire. Didn't kill him, actually. Tempo's slacking. There we go. All right, we want a key here. We want a key.
This expedition at least promises success.
We do want busts too. All right, well, let's get rid of our 3 shovels. And yeah, I think we're just gonna go north and then head to the east, and that'll be it. Free stress heal for Tempo. What's the chance of a key being attached to a torch? Very unlikely. Got it.
In Radiance, may we find victory.
We already know this is, I believe, I think it's just a scrawling, isn't it? No, it's books. We're not going to be burning the books. Don't ever burn those books. Even if someone tells you to, don't. I'm not going to tell you what happens, but trust me, it's not what you want. All right, well, let's get our welfare artifact here, even though we have a key. It's kind of depressing, actually. Oh, man. All right, we'll get rid of the food here. All right, well, I mean, super easy run. You can't really complain about it. We ended up getting a pretty nice amount of gold, actually, all things considered, even though we didn't get a real artifact. And we got a lot of crests. We also get the Wounding Helmet, of course, which I'm really, really happy about, because that is a huge early game trinket for the Bounty Hunter. Wow, we got a lot more crests than I realized. We actually didn't get that much gold now that I look at it, but that's okay. Yeah, I came up with 8 busts. We get a couple more out of that. We got a couple of diseases, though. And Fragile is god-awful. Just terrible. So let's do a little bit of a cleanup here before I wrap up this video here.
In time, you will know the tragic extent of my failings.
Let's go ahead and unequip everything. I always make sure that I keep everything organized. Alright, what can we upgrade in the Sanitarium? We can actually increase the treatment ward slots to 2, which is something I definitely want to do. So let's do that. So we have two openings in the negative quirk department now.
Inside the mind.
Let's get that. I believe it was Tempo who got fragile. I want to say it was, yeah. So we're going to have to... Tempo's going to be out for a while. Unfortunately, he's going to be out for a while. Strippin, he's good. Marie, oh, God. Let's go for... yeah. We do sometimes use Marie for damage on the first round. So that's not that out of line. Fear Beast is real bad for a DPS. That's a lot of money, but it's worth it. Boogie's worth it. All right, everyone, I'm going to wrap it up there. Thank you for watching. Thank you for supporting the channel as well. You can also check out my Patreon page, patreon.com/Invicta, if you want to go an extra step to support myself. I do appreciate it. Thank you, everyone, for supporting the Darkest Dungeon series as well. I really am excited and enjoying the game, and I'm glad that everyone else is. So I'm going to wrap it up there. Until next time, so long, everybody!